Hi, my name is Jake Michels. I am a technical marketing engineer at Yageo Group, and I have an electrical engineering degree from Montana State. And essentially what I do is make material for engineers so that they can select our parts and give them the tools to make powerful decisions.
Can you briefly explain the role of EMI filters in switch mode power supplies and how they're used to prevent common mode and differential mode noise from propagating to other equipment?
So inside of a switch mode power supply, making those switching occurrences creates noise in the system. And so essentially what we want to do at common mode or differential mode, we want to divert a pathway to allow that energy to dissipate, allow that noise to exit the system without interfering any of the other equipment.
Jay, can you talk about the importance of filtering in sensitive applications like medical, industrial, and consumer applications? And why noise on the supply voltage rail can cause unexpected results in these applications.
So filtering in sensitive applications, it's all about data integrity, right? We're trying to preserve the amount of information that gets transferred throughout the system.
Can you tell us about the use of polypropylene and paper in safety capacitors?
So paper and the paper-zinc capacitors, they're used because they self-heal. And so when that happens, when you get a voltage spike or something from a lightning strike, you actually get a little bit of burning inside that capacitor, and it leaves back carbon residue. To maintain the insulation resistance of that component, we need it to kind of self-heal. And so the paper zinc combinations actually work the best.
Can you explain the EMI suppression capabilities of these capacitors?
Performance of these capacitors is dual function. So the first function is the electrical function, right? So we're trying to mitigate our common mode noise, our differential mode noise, and remove that from the circuit. But the second one is a safety function, which is dictated by an approval agency. In our case, it's UL.
What are the differences between the X and Y capacitors and their specific suitable application?
So an X-rated capacitor, an X1 or an X2, is rated is a line-to-line capacitor. So in a three-phase system, you would tie it from A to B to B to C and then C to back to A. That's strictly mostly for fire protection, and it's differential mode filtering is what occurs on that. The Y capacitors actually are for electrical shock. They're tied to ground, so they would go A to ground, B to ground, C to ground. And they're stopping electrical shock. They're filtering out common mode noise.
How does the temperature humidity bias, or THB, test affect the performance of these capacitors?
So the higher grade, the higher the THB grade, the lower rate of degradation occurs in these capacitors in those conditions.
So are there any specific benefits of the miniaturized X2 versions of Kemet's capacitors?
So right now, the trends across the board, and this has been going on for decades, is everything's smaller, faster, cheaper.
Thank you, Jake, for answering the top questions about EMI filters and capacitors in switch mode power supplies. To learn more, visit Mouser Electronics' website.